Hello, thank you for joining me. I'm at Coate Water Park in Swindon. This reservoir was built to provide water for the Barks and Wilts Canal, which has since closed. So that's the dam up there. You can see an old diving board, which is no longer used. The reason we're here today, though, is I'm out with Railtrail Tours, holiday company who does some brilliant tours all around the UK, from Europe and the rest of the world. And the tour I'm on at the moment is called the Lost Village of Imber. So tomorrow we're going to go to Imber, this lost village, which I'll probably have to do a different video on. But today, day two, we have a special charter here at the Coate Water Miniature Railway. So we're going to go for a ride. We'll have a look at what's going on, which locos are running, and then we're going to go from here to the Somerset and Dorset Railway. But as we come into their railway, they really have got quite a lineup for us here. You can see there's a lovely American Mikado, class 66, and there's also a class 40 just over there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to have a ride hopefully behind this beast and enjoy the morning here.
See you next year. Thank you.
Brilliant trip behind this American loco. Going up those gradients was amazing. So what we're going to do now, we've been given permission to go over to the engine shed. So we'll wander over there and we can see some of the other locos which are currently on shed, and then it'll be time for us to go. Well, we'll do a bit of line siding, then once we go, we'll go to the Somerset and Dorset Railway. So they've said I can come down here. So we walk along over this bridge, over a ditch. This is a running line I'm crossing, so I've got to make sure no trains are coming, there's nothing coming, so cross here. And this is the sheds and the steaming bays just here. So here we have, well, we've got quite a lot. We've got an A3, one of Flying Scotsman's little sisters, Dick Turpin. Let's go and have a closer look. So this is 7 1/4. Is the class 66, the class 50 and the class 52 Western. These three diesel locos are 5 inch. So you can see this is 5 inch, that's 7 1/4 inch. And then being steamed up behind us with a Red Rose headboard is a Britannia number 7 00052, Firth of Tay. So the two surviving Britannias are of course Oliver Cromwell and Britannia. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to hang around here, see if they'll start up some of these diesel locos. Well, they're actually electric, but models of diesels, because when they start up they sound pretty good. So we'll see them start up, do a bit of line siding, and then we'll go to Midsomer Norton for see the Somerset and Dorset Railway.
Thank you.
So here we are, we have arrived at Midsomer Norton, the home of the Somerset and Dorset Railway. If you look that way, there's not a great deal to see, but the track bed used to go that way. But if we turn around, we can see they have started to restore and rebuild the line. Midsomer Norton Station was always known for having really attractive gardens. So what's happening is we're going to go for a ride up the line. This loco is on the rear of the train to bring the train back, this British Railways shunter. So we'll walk up the platform and I'll show you what our motive power is to take us up the line. So we've got three Mark 1 coaches here for the journey. It's about a mile of track they've restored, and it is all uphill, so you get the steam loco has to work, which is what we always like to see on any heritage railway. If we have a look here though, as we pass, there's the old goods shed. See another steam locomotive, Austin number 1. Now I had this one at Chinner back in the 90s. If you have a look at the link on screen now, you can see that video. It's like a work at Chinner in the 1990s. And then we come to here. Here is one of the most unusual steam engines I've ever seen. It's a Sentinel vertical boiler loco. So you can just see the boiler is vertical. And I understand it works. Oh, they've just fired a 08 shunter up. But I understand it works with the fillings are here in front and they drive chains. So I'm not sure where the 08 shunters are to, but it looks as though it might be about to depart. I've just found this very interesting little museum about the war. If you're wondering what on earth this building is, I'm actually inside a pillbox. I've never seen a pillbox so nicely restored. You often see them in the corner of fields and, you know, they're always not the nicest of places. But look at this, they've really gone and made a really nice little museum out of a pillbox, which I think is really, really quite nice. You'll see in a moment where we are. We're not far from Midsomer Norton station, in fact we're very close, but have a look, I've got all these little artifacts on display here. And then it says mind your head. And you may have just heard something from a bit after the war, a diesel loco. If you look down there, there's another ex shunter. And that's Midsomer Norton station. So this is our final view of the coach. Oh look, there goes the 08, let's see that. A final view of the Somerset Dorset Railway. I'm going to head back to the coach. I hope you enjoyed this video. And you know, if you want to come on a day out like this, then do have a look on the Railtrail Tours website. Have a look at what they do. We do lots of tours to lots of interesting places like this. So do have a look and see what takes your fancy. So I'm going to head back to the coach, which is parked just down there. So I hope you enjoyed this video from Midsomer Norton Station. Thank you very much for watching. Please do feel free to like, subscribe, and comment. I'm going to give you one final look overshed and I'll say goodbye.